Hello, very good morning. Today I am going to start science of class 8 from chapter sound. So today we will discuss about sound. This is the first video and I have planned to complete the chapter sound in by 4 or 5 videos. So this is part 1. Let us discuss. So first I would like to define the sound. What is sound? Sound is a form of energy which produces the sensation of hearing in our ears. Means sound एक energy का ही एक रूप है, एक form है, जो हमारे कानों में सुनने की संवेदनशीलता, that is sensation of hearing, इसको पैदा करता है, produce करता है, and we can hear a sound. In our daily life, there are various objects. Whether it may be living or non-living, they all produce sound. For example, in at our home, the various family members, we can hear the sound of our various family members. We can hear the sound of whir of fan, that is rotation when fan moves, rotates, its blades rotates, and we can hear the sound of a falling object on the floor. We can hear the sound of television. We can hear the sound of radio. We can hear the ringing sound of mobile phone or telephone. And outside, we can hear the sound of motor vehicles. We can hear the sound of motor horns. And in the garden, we can hear the sound of chirping birds. We can hear the sound of leaves when it strikes through each other, and we can hear the sound of wind when it strikes through leaves. And at music concert, we can hear the sound of various musical instruments. So, and sound plays an important role in our daily life. The next, each sound is special to the object which produces it. That is, an object that produces a sound, the sound produced by that object is special. For example, just observe. We can take an example from our surroundings. For example, when we press a switch, electric switch, which type of sound is produced? When a fan rotates, which type of sound is produced? And when we ring a cycle bell, which type of sound is produced? And we press a horn of a motor vehicle, which type of sound is produced? So these all are the different objects, and different objects produce different types of sounds. That's why we can say that each sound is special to the object which produces it. So by listening that particular type of sound, we can identify that which type of an object is producing such sound. The next, source of sound. What are the sources of sound? Means where does the sound come from? Its answer is very simple. A vibrating body or a vibrating object produces sound. So here a new term is introduced, vibration. So let us first define the vibration. Vibration is back and forth or to and fro, that is aage piche. Back and forth or to and fro motion of an object about its mean position is called vibration. Back and forth, aage or piche, or to and fro, aage ya piche ka motion about its mean position. Let us understand this with the help of example. You all would have seen some part of iron rod from a side of the building or on the top of a building, or generally we see that on some of the floor of the building, on the second floor or third floor, some part of the iron is left for the further construction. Suppose this is the roof of the building, top of the building, and some part of the iron rod is left. for the further construction. Just press this rod one side. See, we pull this rod to one side and just release it and observe what happens. We see that this iron comes to this point and then starts vibrating. In the other side, it goes here and starts vibrating. And if we try, we can hear a very faded sound, very faint sound from this activity. So here, however, I am trying to let you all know about the vibration. What is a vibration? This is the example of vibration. Or toss a coin, and when coins fall on the floor, what happens? Sound vibrates and produces, coin vibrates and produces sound. And the next, what causes object to vibrate? It is how an object is vibrated. What is the reason behind it that vibrate, that makes an object to vibrate? Object kaise vibrate karta hai, iske piche karan kya hai? To make an object vibrate, we require energy. And where does this energy come from? This energy may be from our hand, as we pull the iron rod from one side and release it, and it started vibrating because we supply it to energy. Or it may be wind. The wind passing through a floor produces sound. It may be wind, or it may be electricity. As we press the bell of electric switch, and it starts vibrating and hence produces sound. So we require energy to make an object vibrate. And now we will discuss some of the examples how object vibrates. We will discuss the different types of examples in which objects vibrates and produce sounds. But before moving ahead, here I would like to explain one thing. In some of the cases, we can see when an object produces large sound, then we can see its vibrating. Means we can see that the objects are vibrating. But in some of the case, when it produces low sound, we can't see that objects are vibrating. But if we touch this with our finger gently, then we can feel that the objects are vibrating. Now we will take various examples and watch how the different types of objects vibrate and produce sound. Now I have noted some examples on the board that will show that a sound is produced by vibrating objects. These all examples are very common. We can see and observe it on our surroundings. Ringing a bicycle bell. Just ring a bicycle bell, and please, we can't see the vibrating bell. However, we can hear the sound when we will ring a bicycle bell. But we can't see that the objects are vibrating because it produces a low sound, so its vibration is also low. So we can't see it, but we can feel it when we will touch it gently with our fingers. So ring a bicycle bell and touch the plate, that is bell of the bicycle, with your fingers, then we can feel that some shaking movement. It is shaking back and forth. And if we tight our hand on the bicycle bell, it stops vibrating and also it stops producing sound. So from this example, we can conclude that only vibrating body can produce sound. As bell is ringing and it is vibrating, then it produces sound. But when it stops vibrating, that is as we hold it tightly by our hand, it stops vibrating. So it also stops producing sound. Let us see the next example. A stressed rubber band. Let us take two nails and take a rubber band and stress it and tie this rubber band to the two nails tightly. Now this is the original position. Now look at this figure. We just plug the rubber band on one side, that is from A, and here broken line indicates the original position of the, that is mean position of the rubber band. Now plug this rubber band to one side, say up to the position 1.1, and release this. As we release, it will start vibrating about its mean position. As I have discussed earlier that objects moves to and fro most way about its mean position. So this broken line indicates the mean position, and as we plug the band one side, it will start vibrating. It will go from A to its original position, then from original position to B, that is other side, and again it comes to its original position and comes to A. And this motion is called vibration. And it starts vibration, it also produces sound. And in this case, we can see the vibrating rubber. And the next, sitar. Sitar is a musical instrument which has a stressed string. When we plug the string, it produces sound. And when we touch it gently, we can feel its vibration, that is its shaking movement. The next, when we talk, as I am speaking, the sound is also being produced. How does this sound produced? This sound is produced by the vibration of vocal cord, that is in our throat. How this vocal cord produces sound? When we try to speak, the air from the lungs passes up the windpipe and the vocal cord gets contracted, and the air that has been passed by the lungs rushes through that vocal cords and produces sound. The next, blowing an empty test tube. Take an empty test tube and blow air into it by your mouth. It will produce sound. It's very common. We can do it at our home. The next, heating the stressed membrane of tabla or drum. The skin of tabla is called membrane. When we heat or beat a tabla, membrane of the tabla, it produces sound. However, we can't see its vibration, but in order to feel this vibration, you just put something, a small lighter object on the membrane of the tabla or drum, and then beat the tabla, membrane of the tabla or drum. Then we will observe that the objects that was kept on the membrane starts jumping up and down. This shows that when we beat the membrane, it starts vibrating and hence produces sound. So these are the examples that show that objects produces sound. It can't produce sound unless it vibrates. Jab tak koi bhi object vibrate nahi karega, tab tak wo sound produce nahi kar sakta. As we ring the bell of a bicycle, this way we made the bicycle bell to vibrate and hence produces sound. The next case, we plug the rubber band and make it to vibrate, and hence produces sound. And the next case, we plug the stressed string of a sitar to make it vibrating and hence produces the sound, and so on. So from the above examples, we can conclude that only vibrating body produces sound. Now I will discuss the next point. Let me rub the board. Hence, from the above discussions, we can conclude that sound can be produced by the following methods, only by the following methods. The first is by vibrating a string, as in sitar. In sitar, vibrating string produces sound by vibrating air column, as in test tube. In test tube, you blow the test tube and air column inside the test tube vibrates and produces sound. By vibrating membranes, as in tabla or drum, as we beat the membrane of tabla or drum, it starts vibrating and produces the sound. By vibrating plate, as in bicycle bell, as we ring the bicycle bell, its plate starts vibrating and produces sound. In the next topic is propagation of sound, that is transmission of sounds. So far we have discussed that a vibrating body produces sound, but we can feel that the sound, whatever we hear, comes from a distance. So here a question arises: how sound travels from its source position to our ears, to the ear of listeners? साउंड कहीं और प्रोड्यूस होता है, हम लोग इसको फील कर सकते हैं और इसको हम लोग सुनते हैं, तो कैसे ये सोर्स पोजीशन से, जहां से ये प्रोड्यूस हो रहा है, वहां से हमारे कानों तक कैसे पहुंचता है? लेट अस डिस्कस दिस. एज वी नो दैट अ वाइब्रेटिंग बॉडी प्रोड्यूसेस साउंड, सो अ बॉडी वाइब्रेट्स इन द एयर मॉलिक्यूल्स अराउंड इट, ऑल्सो पुश्ड बाय द वाइब्रेटिंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स, and it also starts vibrating. And now the air molecules next to that air also, that is next layer of air molecules, also starts vibrating. And in this way, this process goes on the next, and by this, that vibrating molecules of air reaches to our ear and we feel it as sound. That is, we feel that vibrating molecules of air and it fills us as sound. This way the sound is propagated. That is, sound, the transmission of sound is done in this way. And in the, I stop right over here. And one thing that I want to know by you all, that which medium, if you like this video, please leave your comment in the comment box. And just it may be just advice that which language should I follow, English, only English, or Hindi, or both language. Just leave your opinion in the comment box. And if you, this video is helpful to you, or you feel any lacking in this video, please feel free to give your advice. Thank you.